Okay, hello guys, welcome back to the New Game Plus runs. We are at the start of chapter 9 and we are going to run straight into it because this is a very long chapter. Basically, we have to revisit the six worlds, and open up the third continent and find all of Chou-Chou's gems. Okay, so remember, first time through we couldn't get 300%, but now we can. And the first master point is right here. Which we have to pay 2,000 gold. The next master point is over here, where we're going to want to use a talisman. Because the stupid carrot and stupid pig won't leave you alone, I promise you. Actually, I'm going to start abusing talismans a lot more. To be honest, like, I knew they existed, I didn't want to take the time to look through my items and use it. Silly me. Well, that's what I'm here for, you guys can learn from my mistakes. I am all for using talismans, they're good. Alright, so for this master point, we want to use 6,000. Which leaves one last master point, which isn't that far. Surprisingly, these master points are very easy to find, and they're not hard to fulfill. There aren't that many enemies around. It's just overall an easy time. And look, they even left us a save crystal to leave easily. So that's the second continent of Moon World down. That just leaves the third continent for us to explore, and 300%, just like always. But first, we have to revisit G Castle because why not? Okay, fine. We're back in control. And we're heading straight back to Moonworld to go to Land of Seven Lights. Is this like a shrine to acknowledge the existence of the other six worlds? Okay, I have to do some quick remembering of how this one works. Okay, right, okay. So, after you hit that first master point, you're going to want to come here, pay 3,000 for that master point, and Moe Kill that one as well. Then, we're going to go ahead, turn around real quick, and take this teleporter. You're going to want to take the teleporter on the right first, because there are master points back here. Master points 2 and 6, I believe. Already we got 100%, so we're making good time here. Right, it is master point 2 and 6. Getting away from that scarecrow is kind of tricky. Oh, no, not 6, it's 2 and 3. Where'd I get 6 from? Alright, I'm just gonna do it. You guys don't want to see me fight. I did plenty of it in my Let's Play. And I even did plenty of it in this series. I was supposed to have 0 fights, and I've done, 20. Anyways, after you get those two master points back there, we're gonna want to head back this direction. Once you get to this point, it's pretty straightforward. Actually, it's not pretty straightforward. It is straightforward. There's nothing over there. So you can go the next few teleports until you get to this angel statue. then you're gonna find the last few master points over here. First of them being over here, to our left. And then another one right here, behind these little floaty diamonds and pillars. Then into the last area, where there are two more. For this ninth master point, we're going to want to pay 60 grand. Make sure you stay away from that event point, because if you trigger, you're going to have to run all the way back over here. And there we go, 300%. That is third moon continent down. Pick that up just for good measure. And trigger this event. For a quick teleport out after story. After plot battle. Okay, so, I'm not 100% sure, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Yeah, okay. Phew, risky. I suggest you don't try to Moe Kill everybody. Just go for the, just go for the large crystal. Just to be safe. Now for the Beleria fights, you can Moe Kill everything. I'm pretty sure it's safe. But for the monster fights, you're gonna want to go for the large crystal. Right, so I don't remember how many. I think we do have to fight Beleria 3 times, but I don't remember on which continents.
I'll show you an overwhelming victory.
They're not too tricky. If your percentage is high enough, then you can just Moe Kill her. Whoa. Actually, item killed the large crystal. How bad of me. Ooh, 150 Shamyaos. That's lovely. Alright, so that should be the end of this. And we're going to be taken back to G Castle, where we will go to Fire World. You guys remember, each world, or going to each world, shows dialogue between the dialogue from the hero. Most of the time, they're mad that the monsters are running rampant, like in this one. It's Alis and Elka, and her fans are happy that Alis has come to save them. Alright, who we are? We are in control of Chou-Chou. And since it's our second visit, we can work on 300%.
I like you.
So, the master points are actually kind of tough. They were tough for me to find. Me personally. I'm pretty sure two of them are down here. Yeah. This one and Master Point 5, which we will be having to pay 4,000 for. Those aren't how much you have to pay, but those are like the easy amounts to pay. Okay. We get it, you found me. Made me waste a few seconds. Alright, so after you hit those events, you want to remember to pick this one up. it would be... It's pretty easy to forget that that's even there. But after you get that, we're gonna come pick this last master point up right here. Claim our well-deserved shampoos and head for the exit. Thankfully, the exit point isn't too far from here, but it's not really that close either, honestly. Alright. Third continent open. I wish you would load faster. See, what time are we at now? Wow, 11 minutes and I'm only two continents, or two worlds in. I've got four more, jeez. This is definitely gonna be the longest episode. Well, I did warn you guys, this is the second longest chapter. But chapter 10 easily takes the cake. Right, so right off the bat, you want to make sure to grab the first master point there. Then you don't have to worry about any more on this little island. I'm gonna call these little teleporting segments islands. For the second continent island, you're gonna want to get that master point. This fight with the pterodactyl is unavoidable unless you use the talisman. But, meh. Actually, it probably would have been smart for me to use the talisman. Alright, before we head to that left teleporter, we're gonna want to come over here. We're gonna use the teleporter on the right, pay 11,000, teleport back. That guy respawned fast. Then we're going to take the teleporter on the left. We're going to go ahead and use the talisman, because a battle with that lava turtle is 100% unavoidable. If he doesn't catch you on your way in, he will catch you on your way out. I guarantee it. And if he doesn't, well, man, you're much better than me. Okay, so after you get that way out of the way master point, we will continue and grab this master point. Then on to the next island. You're gonna want to take this path. This route, I mean. And grab this master point. This is the only master point on this island that you have to worry about. So go ahead and teleport. It'll bring you back to the previous island where you can pay 8,000 for your new master point. More peon influence. Always good. Now we're in the last area. Oh, well. Yeah, I consider this the last area since it's huge, but it has two branching areas. One on the left, one on the right. We're gonna take the left path first. This one has one where you pay for it. Where you could pay 80,000, be on your merry way. Next, we're heading for the right. Make sure not to trigger that event, although it's not really possible unless you try to trigger it. If you ever accidentally trigger an event, you're going to have to sit through all of it, do the fights, and everything. And you're gonna have to run back from the start of the level to the last master points that you had to pick up, so try your best to avoid them. Overwhelming victory. Alright, strategy's the same for this one. Go for the large crystal, everyone else falls afterwards. that, we get 80 Shamyows. Yay, I can already feel the grinding going away. Off into the distance. Chou-Chou's happy planet with happy people. And tiny trees. Apparently the people are bigger than trees. Chou-Chou made a world of titans. Not sure what to say here. These are uncomfortably long skipping events, or event skipping. Anyways, that wraps up Fire World, and we are at 16 minutes, what? Oh my gosh. I'm trying to pick up the pace, but there's nothing I can do. I wonder if I can do this in under 30 minutes. Alright, here we go guys, place your bets. Well, you already know if I did this challenge or not. Me, I don't. This is like a race against myself, really. Alright, so for Waterworld, we only have to really worry about this one continent that we didn't finish our first time through. But, as you know, since it's our second visit, of course we can finish it this time. We already have it at over 100%, we just have to clean up these last few master points. Which is only like two, right? Yeah, just that one I did and two more, so three master points. And the last two are really close to each other. So after you come out of the village, make sure to get these the little star master point and this master point, which you actually have to pay quite a bit, 90,000. Sorry, no one said being undisputed was cheap. Right, so after this, I'm gonna go ahead and use a talisman. And run through all these enemies. I'm glad Gozile reminded me to show these. He saw the my troubles with Waterworld, the second continent, and I have to say these are brilliant. These take out some of the tedium of the second continent, but not all of them. The second continent is still a horrible place. Anyways, we have to face Shadow of the Colossus boss. I don't know why they did that. That's not cool. Shadow of the Colossus was hard. But again, same strategy. It's gonna be the same strategy for all of these fights. Just go for the large crystal. And look, Chou-Chou has a barrier. Oh, we're also done with Waterworld now. Yay! But I guess we're not really done until these cutscenes are over. I like how you can see their lips in these pictures. That's really good detail. And then we all saw Chou-Chou's busty form in the normal ending. How did she turn into a lolly? What happened? Oh well. I won't argue with the game. Plus, I have no right to. I'm not undisputed. Chou-Chou is. Alright, okay, now we're done with Waterworld. That just leaves Tree World. Second continent of Tree World, to be exact. Look at Sharu's hat. That's awesome. It looks like there's a little glowy lamp in there. Now, normally, I'm not a hat person. Actually, not normally. All the time. I never wear hats. I don't even think I'd wear Sharuru's hat. If I had a hat that could show my same emotions. Yep. Sorry. No hats for me. And if you want to know why I don't wear hats, I'll just say, like, my hair is, I have my hair like Fang from Fairy Fencer F. Yeah, so you can do the rest from there. Okay, that stupid thing, he's in my face. So I'm gonna use the talisman to make him go away. Shoom. Ha! Yeah, he's actually really hard to get around. Especially if you want to get that master point next to the giant mushroom. Yeah, as long as you follow the path I take. I've checked for, like, variant routes that were faster or something, and so nothing. I think I have the optimal route down. The way I take it is I go master points that are closest, because not all of the master points show up until you get your peon rate at a certain percentage. What am I doing? Sorry, I'm used to my old run-throughs. Where I used to save before every event. So that's probably why I have like 150 hours played, because I was so careful. Again, large crystal. Boom. Easy. And this is where we're going to have another Beleria encounter. And after this Beleria fight, then we are done with Tree World. Ooh, we're at 23 minutes. I'm gonna cut this pretty close. Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to break 30. I don't think I'll be able to beat 30 minutes. Darn. But is it really my fault? Is there something that I could have done that could be faster? Or is it because of this unruly skip time? Now apparently Mugen Soul Z is a lot better. Is a lot better about their events and load times. I can't say personally. I have the game, but I haven't played it yet. Because I haven't reached 100% platinum status. But yeah, maybe I'll play it over Christmas, since I won't have anything else to do. Pff, yeah, right. I have lots I could do. Like, I might actually have to... Actually, I don't think I have to do anything. All I have to do is enjoy myself before classes start up again for the next semester. Yep, I don't get a measly 2 weeks off anymore. Now I get like a whole month. And that's wonderful. Wait, I was just at Tree World. Okay, so yeah, I failed. I messed up big time. No, I didn't mess up that bad. I just wasted a few seconds. Okay, we're at Metal World. This is the last one. Man, I don't know how I'm gonna do the next chapter. I'm beating myself up thinking about it. I actually wanted to fight this guy, because he has some... there's some valuable shampooeries. Well, valuable considering where he's at in the story. I mean, he doesn't give tier 15 shampooeries, but he gives a decent amount. So yeah, sorry, forgive me, I had to fight him. Right, so, as you guys remember, we couldn't get 100% last time, but now we can. And here's that event that I thought I missed that I really didn't. What was I doing, man? I'm crazy. I'm sorry. I did a lot better than I thought I did. Okay, so let's just ignore I did any of that and pay 35,000 for this master point. Take this master point. Now, there are only two more master points left. This is one of those two, right here behind this barrier, next to the box. And there, it's ours. Now the last ones in this area. It's over here, right? Yeah, got around them. You hug the wall and come to this, whatever this thing is. The last master point is here. They call it a barrier. Last time I checked, barriers were to surround things. That's not surrounding anything, it's like two barriers inside of one another. It's barrierception. Anyways, off to the final frontier. Which is actually our final frontier. This is the last place where we want to be. It's also the last continent we uncover, the last continent we will visit. The last everything. How's it feel, guys? We are so close to the end, you know? Loading up, loading up, loading up, loading up. Ah, let me in. Alright, so right off the bat, you want to take this last point to the right, then head to the left. You have to do it in that order, because the one on the left won't show up unless you take the one on the right. Sorry, I don't make the rules, I play by them. Next, at the branching path, you take a right, and pay 5,000 for this. Wait, that's 50. 5. 5, you say. Now, we continue straight. Pick up this master point right here. And claim our 100% prize. Hooray! Sneak past that purple thing. Grab this master point right here. Turn around. Run with the beast. Again, this is a pretty straightforward map. Not really difficult to find the master points. So long as you have a general idea where they're at. Thank you. Now, I think there's only three more master points after that one. One is right here. Another. I'm gonna run straight through all these enemies. That's right, I just did that. Ooh, I feel so good. Okay. That was the second to last one. Now we're gonna get the final master point in the game. That is right here. Now, it's triggered. Oh, okay, wait. Let's claim our prize, then trigger this event. Good job, guys. We took care of all of those master points.
This looks like a fun match.
Now we have to face this giant energy breaker and a killer sheen. But they are no match for me. Yeah, for that fight, you're going to want to pee on them directly. Unless you match the Moe of the large crystal. You can always go for the large crystal if you're not really confident. But that finally ends chapter 9. Phew! Big sigh of relief. Big sigh of relief. 31 minutes. That's a pretty long chapter, almost 32. And that leaves one final chapter. I still don't know how I'm gonna do this. I don't know. I'll go ahead and ask on Twitter. That's a good way to find out. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope you're finding this useful. Be sure to join me for the last episode of this series. And yeah. Hope you've enjoyed so far. I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.